feels at night, I feel it deep inside, without you, yeah. Know how to satisfy, keeping that tempo right, without you, yeah. Pictures in my mind on replay, I'm gonna touch the pain away. I know how to scream my own name, scream my name. I love me, gonna love myself, no, I don't need anybody else. Hey, gonna love myself, no, I don't need anybody else.
All right, all right, all right. It's been a while, been a month or more, who knows. But I'm back. Just wanted to start up another video blog, talk about something that's been on my mind, thinking about my coming out journey and all that. I know we left off somewhere with me coming out before I started my new career in, or my career in public accounting, in the accounting industry. So a lot of new things are happening. Came out to my family, came out to my friends. Starting a new job, was studying for the CPA, meeting a lot of coworkers, working with clients, just a lot of overwhelming things going on. But yeah, it was awesome. So one story that was sticking in my head in terms of my job, my new job, and my coming out journey was when I was seeing a client in California with my boss, who was a senior auditor. I was an associate auditor at the time, and super Christian dude, which was awesome. You know, got to be yourself. I totally respect him for that. And he was, for the most part, pretty respectful, pretty nice to me. We talked about my sexuality for a little bit, on and off. He brought it up, I brought it up, can't really remember. And, you know, he listened, wasn't really interested in being open-minded about different way of thinking, you know, which is fine. You know, for a while I was raised in the Catholic Church, so I was on a one-track mindset, and there was no room for any other opinions, any other truths, any other facts. So I understand that mindset, and there's absolutely nothing wrong with it. But an interaction I had with him on that trip, which I look back to and just laugh at myself, especially now, and the more mature I get and the more aware I become of myself, my passions, how people interact, how I interact with other people. It's just kind of, it's funny but also sad to think that how my mind used to work. So anyways, let me get to that. We were leaving work one day from the client. We're going to the hotel and we were talking about our routine basically for the next week or two. You know, does he work out? Do I work out? We're going to get dinner together. You know, that kind of thing. And we talked about how, you know, I think like I like to have a little food, drink some water, and then go to the gym and then work up an appetite to eat a big dinner. Whereas he was the opposite. He likes to get done with work, go to the gym, and then eat dinner and just relax the rest of the night. So we're like, okay, well, I guess our schedules are a little off. No big deal. But somehow we got to talking about our routines at the gym, like what, how we like to work out. And then on top of that, we talked about how, you know, do you grunt when you're working out? Do you make noises? Do you breathe heavy? This and that. It's really weird. I don't know how we got to that. And I remember telling him, like, yeah, you know, every once in a while I kind of breathe heavy. Or like, if, you know, if I'm pushing up a bench press, I'll be like, you know, kind of like push through with a heavy breath, or kind of, you know, grunt a little or this or that. And my coworker was just got really weirded out by it. It was like, you know, oh my God, you're one of those guys, blah blah blah. And I remember at the time being super affected by that. I remember being very self-conscious about it, and going forward, every time I went to the gym, I tried to be super careful about, you know, breathing heavily while I was working out, or grunting, or making any slight noise that was like a strenuous noise. And I tried to stop. I tried not to do it. And looking back, I'm like, wow, what are you doing? What are you doing? Oh, my God. Like, I have no problem taking people's advice and listening to people about their beliefs and the way their mind works. But I let his opinion, his critical judgment on a breathing technique for the gym super affect me, super change me, super make me super self-conscious about myself. I cared so much about the way people thought of me, from my toenails to my hair, like my whole body, my all ins and out, my sexuality, the way I breathe during the gym. I mean, this is just so deep rooted. I can recognize that because of my constant rejection and hate towards myself in terms of sexuality. So I totally understand it, but it's funny and sad to think that I allowed that one conversation to affect my gym workout so much, where I don't push myself as much as I'd like to, or you know, I don't grunt at my last rep of bench press, or I don't breathe heavy, you know, so I'm not stressed. It's just sad, and I know it's not just me who takes people's opinions as serious as I do, or as serious as I have. I'm way better now. I'm still working on it, still a work in process. But just in case anybody else can resonate with that story, do not let opinions like that affect your lifestyle and your mindset and your emotions and your happiness. Be yourself, always and forever.